catch cheating in golf. Greetings, athletes. Today, we're going to talk about something really exciting. We'll be discussing how people cheat in golf and how you can catch them. So, let's begin. Play multiple balls on each hole, then only take your best shot. There are people out there playing golf who play three separate balls and score each of them individually. Once the round ends, they add up their best scores for each hole and count that as their round total. Grounding the club into the sand trap. It's not allowed for the golfer to touch a sand trap with their club before they swing to hit the ball. Using extra clubs. A player is only allowed 14 clubs. There are players out there who deliberately use more than 14 clubs, which is clearly cheating. Improving lie. You cannot bend, break, or hack anything growing or fixed if it improves your lie, your stance, or your area of intended swing. Lots of players out there use their clubs or foot to trample down grass around the ball to improve their club's access to it. This is usually done by opponents when the player playing against them has their attention diverted. Marking procedure. Placing a coin or a marker behind the ball, lifting it up, cleaning it, and then replacing it in the same spot is the way the marking is done. Some golfers, to avoid missing from short range, use the marking procedure to gain an unfair advantage. They either place the ball too far in front of the marker or mark the ball to the side and then replace it in the front. Provisional ball. Every ball that a golfer hits should be uniquely identifiable. Hitting exactly the same ball into roughly the same area can lead to all sorts of issues, as it becomes difficult to identify which is which. It's always advisable to be sure of which ball the player is using. Some players take unfair advantage of the confusion otherwise. Identification process. If the ball has finished in a bad spot, for example, in a deep rough or an overgrown area, it becomes really hard to identify, and the player has a right to lift it to see if it's theirs, given that they can't genuinely identify it without picking it up. The legal process to do that is to first mark the position of the ball before lifting it. The player is only allowed to clean the ball if there's a need. Once done, the ball needs to then go back to its original spot. Now, this is where the players tend to cheat by misplacing it. Amnesia. Imagine that you've reached the end of the hole and you ask your opponent what they had. In reply, you get a statement of, "Put me down for a six." But you get slightly suspicious and end up adding up their shots and reach a higher number than that which was declared. Now, you're in a difficult position, but the truth is there's no excuse for writing down a lower score. It is advisable that you always keep a close eye on their scoring. Nudging the ball. A lot of times the ball gets knocked off the tee at the address. After the predicted cry of one by your playing partners, you are well within your rights to re-tee the ball. But in case you accidentally move your ball in other areas of the course, you can't do that. It may well have been totally an accident from which you've received no material gain, but that doesn't matter. It will be considered cheating and the ball needs to be replaced at the original spot. That's it, folks. Make sure you keep an eye out for these pointers and avoid doing that while you're playing. The Sportsman is a role model for honesty and truthfulness. Share with us your experiences in the comments section down below. If you like the video, hit the like button. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.